Thank you so much, Ewan. Now, as part of our Women's Month celebrations, we want to highlight South African women who are doing amazing things to make the country a better place. And our guest this morning is one of those inspiring women. Now, Taryn Lock and her husband, Athol Williams, founded Read to Rise in 2013 to tackle the issue of illiteracy in the country. Taryn was named one of Mail and Guardian's top 200 young South Africans in 2014 for her work in civil society through Read to Rise, and she is part of the inaugural Obama Foundation African Leaders Program in 2018. Let us give her a very big welcome. Taryn, so good to have you on the show this morning.
Thank you, Leanne. It's so wonderful to be here.
Oh, I tell you, things like this make me so happy, but you know what? It's also work that a lot of people, you know, you're like one of the unsung heroes of our communities doing amazing things. But you want to tell us what made you decide to start your organization, Read to Rise?
Right. Illiteracy is such a huge challenge in South Africa. We have 78% of grade 4 learners in South Africa that are functionally illiterate.
Wow.
And I felt I just needed to do more. Yeah. For me personally, reading is so important. I grew up with books. I love going to the library. And I believe that reading founds the foundation for everything.
Yeah.
It helped me excel at school and go on to university and get a good job. So about 5 years ago, I decided that I would quit my corporate job. I was a strategy analyst, and I wanted to follow my passion for literacy and doing social good in the country. I think that South Africa has so many social ills.
Yeah.
And I think we all need to play our part as citizens.
Yeah, absolutely. So how has the program grown since its inception?
Well, we started in September 2013. So we're actually celebrating our 5th birthday next month. But we've come a long way. We now have 5 classroom programs.
Yeah.
And we work with 70 primary schools in Mitchells Plains, Soweto, mm-hmm. and in Mikado, which is in the Limpopo.
Amazing.
And to date, we've given out over 120,000 brand new books.
Yeah.
And I'm proud to say that over the last 5 years, that 70,000 children have benefited from the Read to Rise programs.
Wow. But you know what they say about a book? It's like the gift that just keeps on giving. And you're so empowered when you read it. It opens up a world that you did not know existed
Absolutely.
Outside maybe your direct community or circumstances that what might seem very dire at the
exactly.
time. What are some of the events that have kind of taken place that are taking place with regards to Read to Rise?
Well, like you said, so we work in under-resourced communities, which they struggle with poverty,
yeah.
gangsterism, drugs. Many of the schools don't have functional libraries. So what we do is we go into the classes to get children excited about reading. So we go to classes and we conduct a program, and we go through lessons, we read them a book, we discuss the story, we sing a song. And a very important part of the program is giving each child their own brand new book to take
wow.
home. Because we hope that by giving a child a book, that'll instill a love for reading
yeah.
in that child. And the books that we use are based on the Oki series, which Athol wrote. He's an award-winning poet, and I illustrated mm-hmm. the books. Mm-hmm. But each of the books has a positive life lesson,
awesome.
Such as being brave or being compassionate
yeah.
and also being happy with yourself,
yeah.
which is much needed in those communities.
That's powerful. Before we run out of time, how can the public help you?
Well, we rely on the public for sponsorships.
Yeah.
So for just 50 Rand per learner, a child can benefit from the Read to Rise program and receive a book to take home.
That is amazing. Well, I definitely hope that people out there would have listened and definitely want to reach out and help out, because I think it's an incredible organization. Thank you so much, Taryn. Read to Rise, definitely something that we should all be a part of, because when we empower our youth through education, of course, we change their lives and we change the world as we do that as well.